Good morning students, welcome back to our new video. In today's video, we will do revision from chapter 1, the sentence. In our previous video, we have learned what is a free sentence and clause. Today, we will learn kinds of sentences. But before starting our video, first we will do a quick recap of what we have learned in our previous video. So in our previous video, we have learned what is a phrase, clause and sentence. Phrase is a group of words, clause is also a group of words, and sentence is also a group of words. Phrase, some meaning, means phrase will give you some meaning. And clause, it is made up of subject plus predicate. It means in clause there will be subject and predicate. See, in phrase, group of word does not mean ki koi bhi ek group of word ho phrase ho gaya. Aisa nahi hai. Group of words to ho, lekin unki kuch meaning nikal ke aa rahi ho. At least some meaning ho. So, wo phrase kahe jaate hain. Clause. Clause kya hota hai ki usme subject bhi hoga aapka, predicate bhi hoga, and then wo complete thought bhi denge. Means complete thought kisme denge agar wo independent clause hai. See, clauses are of two types, independent clause and subordinate clause, which we have learned in class 5th also. Independent clause are those clause which give you complete thought, means unki complete meaning hoti hai. Subordinate clause wo clause hote hain jo independent clause ko bhi use karte hain taki unki complete meaning nikal ke aaye. Okay, so now coming to phrase. Phrase verb may or may not be there, means in a phrase there will be verb or may not. मीन्स जरूरी नहीं है कि फ्रेज में वर्ब हो और या वर्ब ना हो. मीन्स कभी वर्ब हो सकता है, कभी वर्ब नहीं भी हो सकता है. बट देर विल बी नो सब्जेक्ट इन फ्रेज, देर विल बी नो सब्जेक्ट. सो बाय ऑल दिस पॉइंट यू कैन से दैट कि फ्रेज भी ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स होते हैं, उनकी कुछ मीनिंग होती है. ऐसा नहीं है कि ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स हैं तो बस वो फ्रेज हो गए, ऐसा नहीं है. उनकी कुछ एटलीस्ट सम मीनिंग होनी चाहिए. वर्ब्स में और मे नॉट बी देयर मीन्स फ्रेज में वर्ब हो सकते हैं और विद वर्ब नहीं भी हो सकते हैं. बट देर विल बी नो सब्जेक्ट. नाउ कमिंग टू क्लॉज. क्लॉज इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स, दे विल हैव अ सब्जेक्ट प्लस प्रेडिकेट. कंप्लीट थॉट, कंप्लीट थॉट विल बी देयर इन अ केस ऑफ इंडिपेंडेंट क्लॉज. नाउ व्हाट इज अ सेंटेंस. सेंटेंस इज अ ग्रुप ऑफ वर्ड्स, इट हैव सब्जेक्ट प्लस प्रेडिकेट प्लस फाइनाइट वर्ब, एंड इट ऑलवेज गिव्स यू अ कंप्लीट थॉट. A sentence can be in a form of a statement, question or exclamatory sentences. Now students, coming to kinds of sentences. So there are total four kinds of sentences. So the first is assertive sentence, then imperative sentences, interrogative sentences and exclamatory sentences. So now we will study this in detail. Now students, moving to kinds of sentences, there are total four kinds of sentences. They are assertive sentence, interrogative sentence, imperative sentence and exclamatory sentence. Now let's see the first sentence, assertive sentence. An assertive sentence says or states something. It means ये ऐसे sentence होते हैं जो कि कुछ बताते हैं आपको. Means ये sentence है कुछ आपको information देते हैं. They are simple sentences. Means assertive sentences are in a form of simple sentences and they are also in a form of statement. Now let's see what is given in your grammar book. Open your grammar book and take out page number 8. Now let's see kinds of sentences. Study the following sentences given here. Mr. Krishna is a good teacher. Second, are you reading a novel with a question mark? Please close the door. What a great painter Picasso was. Now you can see in the first sentence, Mr. Krishna is a good teacher. Here, the sentence is giving you some information that Mr. Krishna is a good teacher. So it is assertive sentence. This sentence is in a form of statement, so it is an assertive sentence. Now see the second given here. Are you reading a novel with a question mark? So where there will be question mark. So these sentences always ask a question. So the sentences which ask a question, they are interrogative sentences. Means ऐसे sentences जो आपसे कुछ questions पूछते हैं, then वो किसमें आते हैं? Interrogative sentences में आते हैं. Now third, please close the door. Now here please is there. So you are requesting someone that please close the door. So when you will request or you will give command someone or advice or suggestion, so they all comes under imperative sentences. Now coming to what a great painter Picasso was with his exclamation mark. So it is very simple, where there will be exclamation mark, it is actually exclamatory sentence because it is giving you a certain feeling. Means which feeling you have nikal ke aane ki what a great painter Picasso was, means you are telling your feelings that kitna achha Picasso painter hai. So you are telling your feelings here. So it is exclamatory sentence. Now coming to first assertive sentences. An assertive sentence says or states something. Now we have told you it is also known as declarative sentences. So they are also called declarative sentences also. And assertive sentences are of two types, negative sentences or positive sentences. Means assertive sentences are divided into two parts. They are negative as well as positive. Now let's see what are the positive sentences. Like Rima is fat. Now Rima is fat is a positive sentence and you have to make this sentence into negative. So how you will make? You will add here not. So not word, nor, nothing, neither. See all these words comes under negative sentence. Means when we want to change positive sentence to negative sentence, then we add these words like nor, nothing, nobody. So these all words are negative words. Now see the second, Mohan and Shoman are best friends. So again it is positive, you have to make it negative. Then you will add here not, then the sentence will become Mohan and Shoman are not best friends. Now see the third one, the wall is painted blue. So you will change to negative, the wall is not painted blue. This is a small garden, this is not a small garden. So assertive sentence can be negative or positive. See all the definitions you have to learn, okay? Now second, interrogative sentences. Interrogative sentences ask a questions, okay? These sentences we always ask a question. They are in a form of yes or no, or they can be in a form of WH questions. Now let's see what are yes or no questions. When were you present yesterday? Were you present yesterday? So if someone asks you that were you present yesterday, so you will give your reply in a form of yes or no. Ki aap us din present the yesterday ki nahi the. So aap answer kis mein denge, yes or no. So, agar aapke answers yes means aapke reply yes and no ki form mein aa rahe hain, then wo kis mein aate hain, aapke yes or no questions ke andar aate hain. Now see the second given here, do you like coffee? So you will give your reply, your answer in a form of yes or no. Yes, yes, I like coffee, or no, I don't like coffee. Third, are we playing hockey? So you will give your reply yes or no. Is mother cooking food? Answer will be yes or no. Now let's see what is WH question. See, in WH questions may start from where, what, why, when, who, how, which. Means these all words comes under WH questions. Now let's see first example, why are you not studying? So here you can't give your answer in a form of yes or no. Means aapke answers, aapke reply yes and no ke form mein nahi hoge. Agar aapse koi puchega why are you not studying, then you will give your answer that maybe I'm not feeling well, or your reasons can be many for not studying. Now see the second, who has brought this book? So your answers will be that Rohan has brought or Sohan has brought. Your answers cannot be in a form of yes or no questions. So they all comes under WH questions. Now see the third, how are you doing? Fourth, when did you come back to Delhi? So you will give your reply either yesterday, tomorrow, or many answers can be there. But your answers cannot be in a form of yes or no. Always put a mark of interrogation at the end of an interrogative sentence. So it is very easy. If you are confused, you are not able to find out what are the interrogative sentence, then in all interrogative sentence at the end of the sentence there will be an interrogation mark. Means the question mark will be always there at the end of the sentence, so you can easily find out that it is interrogative sentence. Now students, coming to imperative sentences. Imperative sentences expresses a command, request, advice or suggestion. Means ये ऐसे sentences होते हैं जो express करते हैं command, request, suggestion और advice देते हैं. Now let's see example given here. Pour a glass of water. So here you are giving command to somebody that pour a glass of water. So it is imperative sentence. Please close the door. So you are requesting someone that please close the door. Be happy. Now again you are giving a suggestion that be happy. So imperative sentences will always give you command, request, suggestion or advice. So they all comes under imperative sentences. Imperative sentences can also be negative. Okay, so imperative sentences can also be negative also. Now see the first given point given. Do not hurry. Do not leave the package at the door. Do not make noise. So here again this is imperative sentence but in a form of negative. Now coming to fourth last one, exclamatory sentences. Exclamatory sentences expresses a strong sudden feeling. Means these sentences आपकी जो स्ट्रॉन्ग फीलिंग को रिफ्लेक्ट करेंगे. जो मीन्स जो सेंटेंसेस होंगे उससे आपको पता चलेगा कि आपकी फीलिंग को बताया गया है. एन एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंस एक्सप्रेसेस अ स्ट्रॉन्ग एंड सडन फीलिंग. एग्जांपल गिवन, आई सिंपली अडोर यू विद एन एक्सक्लेमेशन. सो वन मोर पॉइंट इज देयर दैट इन एक्सक्लेमेटरी सेंटेंस देयर विल बी एक्सक्लेमेशन मार्क. सो इट इज इजी फॉर यू टू फाइंड आउट that it is exclamatory sentence. Means सारे exclamatory sentences में exclamation mark जरूर होगा. So आप इसे देख के भी easily find out कर सकते हैं कि exclamatory sentence है. And उसे पढ़ के भी कि वो sentence आपको कोई feeling बता रहा है कि नहीं, कोई feeling reflect कर रहा है कि नहीं, then आप easily बता सकते हैं कि आपका exclamatory sentence है. Now see the example given here. The Taj Mahal is such a beauty. So here you are giving a sudden feeling कि Taj Mahal एक बहुत अच्छी beauty है. आपकी feeling यहाँ reflect हो रही है. Oh, I didn't see you come in. So you are giving you a emotion that मैं आपको नहीं देख पाई. Fourth, wow, the painting was breathtaking. So you are giving your emotions that wow, painting मतलब बहुत अच्छी चीज. See wow, oh, beautiful. These all words you use when you give your feeling, means when you want to show your feeling, then all these words you use. Oh wow, oh, oh no. So these all are exclamatory sentences. Now see the fifth point given. She, the baby is sleeping. So always put an exclamation mark at the end of an exclamatory sentence. So it is important that in interrogative sentence there will be question mark. In exclamatory sentences, there will be exclamation mark. Now, I hope all of you have understood what are the kinds of sentences. Dear students, if you have any doubt in any point, you can ask me in the comment section below the video. Now, moving to our next topic.
Now, students, open your grammar book and take out page number 10. In this, there is a topic transformation of sentences. It means there are few sentences given here and you have to transform. Transform means you have to change. Study the following example and see how one kind of sentences is converted into another. Means one sentence is given, it can be any kind of sentence, so you have to change to another sentence. So now see the first point given here, assertive into interrogative sentence. Means assertive sentences are those sentences which are in a form of statement. They are simple sentences and now you have to change to assertive to interrogative. Interrogative sentences are those sentences which ask a question. It means statement form ko change karna hai aapko question form mein. Now see example given here, there is a clock on the wall. So you will change like this. Is there a clock on the wall with a question mark at the end? So now here you are asking a question. So now the sentence is changed to interrogative. Second, I can lift this box. So you will change to interrogative. Can I lift this box? So here now you are asking a question by adding can I lift this box. Now see third, Harish is very strong. So you will write like this, is Harish very strong? Fourth, she is allowed to stay up late. So you will write like this, is she allowed to stay up late? So now you can see, now the assertive sentences are changed to interrogative sentences. See, the sentence will be given. So you have to change to interrogative sentences. So it is very easy. जो sentence आपका दिया गया है उसी में से आपको कुछ sentence को आगे करना होगा and then कुछ sentence को बाद में लिखना होगा. जैसे आप last में देखिए लिखा है she is allowed to stay up late. So यहाँ पे जो is था ये is आपने आगे लिख दिया and then आपका पूरा sentence क्या हुआ she allowed to stay up late. So now you are adding here is. Similarly, in third point, you can see Harish is very strong. So here you are adding is. जो आपका Harish is था, is आपने पहले लिख दिया. Is Harish very strong? So now it is in a form of interrogative. So change करना बहुत easy होता है. जो sentence आपको मिला है गया है, उसी में से ही आपको change करना होता है. Now see the second point given. Exclamatory into assertive sentences. Now exclamatory sentences are those sentences which give you a sudden feeling, are used to show a vast range of emotions like love, anger, happiness, confusion, etc. The words order in these type of sentences is slightly different from that in assertive sentences. So now here exclamatory sentences are different from assertive sentences. Now see example given, what a pretty flower with an exclamation mark. So you will change to assertive sentence. Assertive sentence means in a form of simple sentences. So you will change like this, it is a pretty flower. So by adding it is a pretty flower. Second, what a great victory. So you will add here, it is a great victory. So here you are adding it is. Third, how kind of you to help me. So you will add here, it is very kind of you to help me. Fourth, what a bright sunny morning. So you will add here, it is a bright sunny morning. Now see the third point given, imperative into interrogative sentences. So now imperative sentences, they give you command, request, advice or suggestion. So you have to change to interrogative form. Now see first example given, go there. So you will write like this, go there, will you? Second, please close this window. So you will add like this, will you please close this window? Because you have to change to interrogative, the sentences which ask questions. So you will add here, will you? So third, speak loudly and clearly. So you will add here, will you speak loudly and clearly? Fourth, shut up. So you will add here, will you shut up or not? So now you have changed imperative sentences into interrogative sentences. Now students, moving to exercise 5, which is given on page number 11. In this you have to change the following into negative sentences. So positive sentences are given, you have to change to negative sentence. So negative sentence ko पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस को नेगेटिव सेंटेंस में चेंज करने के लिए आप कुछ नेगेटिव वर्ड्स ऐड करते हैं जैसे कि नॉट, नॉर, नथिंग, नेवर. सो दीज ऑल आर नेगेटिव वर्ड्स विच यू ऐड इन पॉजिटिव सेंटेंस टू मेक सेंटेंसेस इनटू नेगेटिव सेंटेंस. नाउ सी द फर्स्ट पॉइंट गिवन, प्लीज ओपन द विंडो. सो यू विल ऐड हियर, प्लीज डोंट ओपन द विंडो. सेकेंड, इज ही अ डॉक्टर. So you will write here, he is not a doctor. They are playing football. So you will change like this, they are not playing football. Go away, don't go away. Garima is intelligent. Garima is not intelligent. Where are you going? Where are you not going? 7. The garden is open for all. The garden is not open for all. This is our classroom. This is not our classroom. 9. Are the girls dancing? The girls are not dancing. Archana is a lazy girl. Archana is not a lazy girl. So now you have changed positive sentences into negative sentences. Now students, all the exercises you have to write in your grammar copy also, and you have to write in your grammar book with pencil. Now students, moving to exercise 6. In this you have to change the sentences as directed. First given point, can you? switch on the light please. So you have to change to imperative sentence. So you will add like this, you will change like this, please switch on the light. Second, she is my best friend. So you have to change to interrogative in a form of question. You will change like this, isn't she my best friend? Third, call her inside. So you have to change to negative. So you will write like this, don't call her inside. Fourth, I never ask you to do it. You will change to interrogative like this, did I ever ask you to do it? Fifth, what a pleasant surprise it is. So you will change to assertive like this, it is a very pleasant surprise. Sixth, is she writing a story? You have to change to assertive, she is writing a story. Seventh, it is available at every shop. You have to change to negative declarative. So you will change like this, it is not available at every shop. Eighth, the hunter has lost his hopes. So you will change to interrogative like this, is hunter has lost his hopes. Ninth, the schools are not closed today. So you will change to assertive, the schools are closed today. Tenth, is the room ventilated? So you will change to assertive like this, the room is ventilated. Because here assertive sentence, so you have to change in a form of simple sentences. So you will write like this, the room is ventilated. So now students, we have completed exercise from chapter 1. Now your homework for today is exercise 4, which is given on page number 10. In this, you have to identify and write the type of following sentences. So you have learned today few kinds of sentences. So you have to find out and then you have to write which kind of sentence is this. So now do your homework, and if you feel any doubt regarding any topic, you can ask me in a comment section below the video. And class, please don't forget to write your name, class, with section for your attendance. Thank you. Be safe and stay at your home.